Hi, welcome to Learning Resource Center South's Learning Create series. My name is Jason Verdun, and I'm from the Learning Resource Center South at Rowan University. And today, we are going to make an interactive weather chart that the students in your classroom or your students at home can chart the weather daily. So we know in an early childhood classroom and a kindergarten classroom, the teacher has a time where they are all together in the morning. Usually it's called large group time or circle time. And part of the activity in your circle time is the weather. So there's many different kinds of weather activities that a teacher does with their students. It could be just simple as looking out the window and talking about the weather. It could be having a weather bear or dressing the bear for whatever weather activity the teacher wants to do with their students. But today we are going to look at making a weather chart. Okay, and I have two different samples here. This one is made of die cuts that you could come to the LRC at Rowan University and make yourself. But since you're viewing this at home, attached to our video will be a link with all our PDFs, and attached to the PDF are going to be the weather pictures. So you're going to download those and cut those out along with the weather words. So what you're going to do is you're going to start out with a 6x28-inch piece of poster board. Okay, and once you download your pictures, okay, you're going to cut them out. We have five different types of weather, and we're going to glue them all on. So I have the type of weather and I have the weather word. This way the students can see the weather and then see what the actual word of the word is. So you're going to put them about an inch and a half apart. So here's our weather chart using our symbols, but like I said, we'll have our PDF. And this is our weather chart with our die cuts, like I said, that you could do with the LRC. This one we can make is a tally chart. So you could get these links if you're a teacher. I'm sure you're very familiar with these. If not, you can order them. So this is the model that if you don't have the links, that you can just use a clothespin. So then the student can, we'll say today's a sunny day, so tomorrow night might not be a sunny day, tomorrow might be a rainy day. So the student would just move the clip. Then if the teacher wants to graph it, you know, he or she can graph it, you know, just according to using the clip. But if you want to use the links, again, using them as science, but also with math, using a tally system, and also number sense and counting. So each day that's sunny, you want to attach the link, okay? So we have lots of sunny days, but we do have some rainy days. So depending on whatever the weather is, the student puts the little clip on, okay? So then we have our tally system. So then again, at the end of the week, the students can count how many sunny days there were, how many rainy days there were, and then by the end of the month you could see which type of weather there was more of. So this is a nice activity because it crosses over into different curriculum areas. So technically it's a science activity, but if you throw the tally activity into that, it could be a math activity. And if you look around some of the things at the table, again, I've used our die cuts to make a what's the weather cube. Teacher can, and a parent, can use open-ended questions with students. Questions like, what do you like to do in the snow? Okay, or using higher level questioning is how does weather influence the clothing we wear and also the activities that we do in that type of weather? Some kids might like to say, I like to go outside and jump in puddles. You know, I like to play in the rain. So there's lots of different things you could do with this activity. And then I have all sorts of different kinds of books. You know, Gail Gibbons is a great informational text writer. So lots of good facts about the weather. So this is about weather words. She writes a book about tornadoes. And then this is a great series, so let's read and find out. Lots of good tech, lots of good information. So I also attached to your to this link is going to be extension activity with it's called Rainbow in a Bag. Okay, so there will be a nice handout right here, Rainbow in a Bag with the directions. Very easy. It's cornstarch, sugar, and water. You cook it till it's thick and bubbles. It's translucent in color. Then you divide it in three different containers. And then you, as you see here, I have red food coloring, yellow, and blue. And we know that they're the three primary colors. So they're the colors that are in all the colors in our world. And you just color each one red, one yellow, one blue. You put a little bit in a Ziploc bag, a lunch bag, and the children can play with it gently. As you can see from mine, I'm playing with it eventually, you will have a nice rainbow. That's a great sensory activity. I thank you for viewing another Learn and Create with the LRC South. So if you stay tuned for additional Learn and Create videos. Thank you.